welcome to the home of the Buccos since 2001, PNC Park in Pittsburgh. It's the home opener of this new season between the Cincinnati Reds and the Pittsburgh Pirates. Folks around here in high spirits. Matt Vaskirjian with you on a day that's been circled on their calendars since about midwinter. Joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, the staffs for these two teams sure to be a focal point as this series moves along.
Hey, just like any team, pitching is going to be the key factor for this ball club as the year plays out. I'm sure the staff will have its ups and downs, but putting together some quality outings early in the season could do wonders for this club getting out of the gate with a good start.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Kenta Maeda gets the ball for the opener in front of these hometown fans. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Kenta Maeda, you're going to see a lot of off-speed pitches from Maeda. 88 to 91 miles an hour, not a terrific fastball, good split finger, good slider. He's one of those guys that pitches backwards. What do I mean by that, Matt? He'll throw fastballs in breaking ball situations, and he'll throw off-speed pitches when he's behind in the count. 2-0 or 2-1, he pitches backwards.
J.P. Crawford is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. And guys, as we take a look at the Pirates coming into this afternoon, they come in as hot as anyone in this first week of the season as they've won five of their first six contests.
Yeah, Matty, a lot of things trending in the right direction for this team. They won their last game, they scored a bunch of runs, and let's see if they continue that today.
Windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Crawford retired, and there's one away. In now for the Reds, Nick Senzel. Previous head-to-head matchups with Kenta Maeda. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Swing and a miss got him reaching. And he makes the throw to first. Senzel is retired, two down now. Base is empty, two away. And in to swing the bat next is Jonathan India. Now a flare out to left center. Cruz is there and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Reds. Now the Pirates will get their first opportunity. No score. Now with the plate is O'Neill Cruz. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
That's shortstop. O'Neill.
The pitch.
1-0.
And guys, these Reds, as they enter play here this afternoon, they come off another loss last time out, and in fact they've dropped three of their last four. Yeah, Matt. Fly ball out toward left center field. Fraley arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. Now a moment here at PNC to take a look at the Pirates lineup card in this one. Mark DeRosa, what's the key to them starting out 1-0 here at home?
Taking a look at this lineup, they're going to have to work the count. That's the key to success right here. They have to find a way to drive this guy's pitch count up and get into that bullpen as quick as possible.
Key Brian Hayes digging in now. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
I think that's one of the toughest calls for an umpire to make. The check swing appeal, hitters rarely feel like they went, and I don't think he likes getting rung up there by the first base umpire. But looking at it, it's hard to say for sure that he didn't go around.
Throw in time, and the side is retired. Second inning coming up from PNC Park with no score. So now the Reds cleanup hitter, Aristides Aquino, will get us started in the top of the second.
Number 44.
On deck, Mike Moustakas. Hit back toward the mound, right to him. On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Take a look at the Pittsburgh Pirates defensive lineup. And when you talk about third base, you talk about a step and a dive. But you better have something to go with it when you get to your knees. And that's what this guy has, an absolute howitzer.
Third baseman Mike Moustakas now. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Previous head-to-head matchups with Kenta Maeda, 2 hits in 7 tries. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw on to first, 2 gone. Now for Cincinnati, Colin Moran. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. First offering. Now 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a 2-out base runner.
Batting 7, the catcher, Tyler.
And now Tyler Stevenson. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and 2 away. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Skied into straightaway right. And as it turns out, the 2-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for Cincinnati. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here comes the first baseman, Bobby Bradley. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Way behind that pitch. It's 0-1. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Reined in. Throw just in time. And oh, that was awfully close. And no surprise based on how close that play was. They're looking at the replay to see if they want to challenge the out call.
Well, here's another look at it. It certainly was bang, bang. Wow, tough for me to tell on that look. Definitely a tough call for the umpire there.
Now the indication from the dugout, and they will use a challenge here. So we'll see what the replay operations center in Manhattan has to say about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Pirates have elected to challenge the...
All right, one last look at it here. The question is there enough evidence to change the call to safe? I think he did beat the throw. This challenge...
The decision appears to have been made, and the runner is safe, so the call is overturned. Good challenge there, and they'll maintain the right to do so again later in the game if needed.
Upon video review, the call of outs at first base has been overturned, and the battle is safe.
Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud, as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. On the ground to third. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And there's one down now.
Okay, here's how the Reds are lining up in this one. And I'm going to focus on J.P. Crawford right now. He is one of the slickest defenders in the game. Real smooth going to his left and right, and he has a bazooka for an arm.
In now, Dylan Carlson. Swings and sends it in the air out to left center. Senzel is there, two gone. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now.
That is seven. No left fielder. Andrew. Vaughn.
Ready now is Andrew Vaughn, runner in scoring position with two gone. Now it's 0-2.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus on making.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. One left for Pittsburgh. We'll move to the third with no score. Take a better stay. Concentrate in my balance. Give life a better chance. I'm too weak. Top of the third set to get underway. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Jake Fraley. Here's the first pitch.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Hot shot to third and handled for the first down.
That is not the pitcher, Luis Castillo.
So one gone now in the Cincinnati third, and digging in to hit next, it'll be the pitcher Luis Castillo. First pitch on the way. Weak grounder down the first baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Third inning, no score to this point. Swing and a miss, and he's in control. 0-2.
Swung underneath that pitch, so he was either trying to elevate the ball or he was expecting a pitch to be a sinker and drop more than it did.
Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes, so it's two up, two down to begin the third.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect for the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
And that'll bring in J.P. Crawford. As he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. But he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Hey, expect a challenge right here. Does not want to run the count full.
Little chopper down the first baseline. Scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Reds are down in order. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Now to bat, Hyun Park. He's ready for his first at bat of his early season contest.
The second baseman, Hyun Park.
The pitch.
Count 1-0.
Now the 1-0. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Senzel's got it, and there's one gone.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, Kenta Maeda.
No one on with one down, and that brings up the pitcher Kenta Maeda. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch. And for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Swing and a liner. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Baseman number 13, Lee Bryant. Hey.
Stepping in now, Key Brian Hayes.
Ball one, no
strike. The first pitch misses to him. It's ball one. 0 for 1 here in the early going. This one's flared down the right field line, and that'll get down for a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Well, D-Roll, that looked like a pretty easy inning to start. All of a sudden, two outs and back-to-back singles, runners at first and third.
Yeah, they put traffic on it. I guess I would throw it back to you, Dan. You get two quick outs right there, and then you get two base hit knocks. Are you even concerning yourself with the traffic on the bases, or are you just trying to execute that next pitch?
You know what happens a lot of times, D-Roll? You lose concentration. You get the first two out in the inning. You think, hey, I'm going to breeze through this and get this pitch.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Pirates strand a couple. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless.
I don't wear a cape or apron, so I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think that's just a statement? And you're ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I ain't new.
Stepping up is Nick Senzel, struck out in his first at bat.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base. That's just what they did right there. Big strikeout. Keep that guy off the base path.
India.
Jonathan India digging in now.
That's a ball.
And a ball 1-0. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
It's a fine line from working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance at getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
And he'll squeeze this one for the second out.
Number 44.
Stepping in once again is Aristides Aquino. He bounced out last time up. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1.
That elevated fastball right there.
That is 1-1.
I got a ball, one strike.
Hit sharply on the ground. Got it. Over to first, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Reds. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score.
Yeah. Who that in the whip? Yeah, you know that's me. You can't stop my shot. I'm just doing me.
Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Bobby Bradley.
The first baseman, Bobby Bradley.
Here it comes. Line to the right side. And that'll get down out there near the wall. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double.
You could tell he was thinking fastball all the way here, and that's exactly what he got. He was able to get the bat hit out front and pull it into the gap at the right center. Now they're set up pretty nicely for a good inning after that leadoff double.
Into the box now, Travis d'Arnaud, as he'll come up empty there as he misses the off-speed pitch for strike one. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Bradley leads off second with nobody out. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
To the plate now, Dylan Carlson, as with one away, he can't make contact on the first pitch. It's strike one.
Fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off speed pitch in the dirt.
Here now the 2-2. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? Andrew Vaughn the next to bat. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. The 0-1 offering.
Ball, that's out.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Here comes the right fielder. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Pirates leave one through four. Still tied, nothing, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to talk about the state of the Reds' offense with their manager between innings.
And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi.
The third baseman.
New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the third baseman, Mike Moustakas. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A solo shot that time for Mike Moustakas. First home run of the campaign for him. As the Reds strike first, it's 1-0.
Yeah, everyone in the stadium, including the guy in the mound, knew it was just a matter of time until this guy cranked one out of here. Well, that's the first one of the year, and many more are sure to follow.
Into the box, Colin Moran.
Colin.
As he'll swing at the first pitch and bang one into right center field, that's a base hit.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
So Standing in now, Tyler Stevenson, as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Man, he's looking sharp so far. 80% of his first pitches are for strikes. He might be able to go the distance if he keeps this up.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Sometimes you just can't overthink it. If a guy can't hit a certain pitch in a certain quadrant, why would you throw him anything else? Case in point, this guy's cold zone is away, and this pitcher keeps attacking that exact spot.
In the dirt. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there.
Well, the graphic here isn't going to properly show just how far that pitch was from the strike zone. That thing wasn't even close, and I think it made the decision to move up a base pretty easy to make.
He's set, and the 1-2 pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
Man, this at-bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. And now in the box, Jake Fraley hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog.
Hold on now. That ball is down and could score a run. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
Everybody's different coming out of spring training. Some guys get off to torrid starts. Some guys struggle. This is one that struggled, but maybe that single gets him going.
Manager brings his outfield in here with the pitcher at the plate. Doesn't want to get burned on any weak bloopers. Stepping in now, Luis Castillo, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. And they're runners at the corners now. The 0-1 pitch.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. 1-2.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
One run on three hits and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. So after getting the strikeout on the fastball, not a bad time to check out our pitch speed comparison for our two starters. And whoa, you see the big number. How about 99 for a top speed? Not too many guys around the league can match that. So the batting order turns over now and set to go J.P. Crawford. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Runners will score. It's now a 3-0 ball game.
Well, maybe the tables have turned a bit. Earlier in the game, the pitcher had his way with him, but he wins the battle this time and in a big way. Two runs on the board as a result.
So now to the plate, Nick Senzel. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. From the stretch.
Ball, that's outside.
Now for four innings, he was great. But here in the fifth, he looks like a completely different guy out there. That happens a lot when a pitcher is facing batters for the second or third time in a game.
Hit softly down the line at first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So three runs on four hits, no errors, and a man left on. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Reds 3 and the Pirates nothing. And welcome back to Pittsburgh as we check in on the field with Heidi.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Derek Shelton during the commercial break about the Pirates offense. And one thing he stressed to me was the need for them to have better at-bats when they've got runners on base. They've had their opportunities with runners in scoring position, but still have zero hits to show for it in those situations. He said repeatedly not coming through with a big hit can wear on you as a team, but in this sport, you have to dwell on the positives. He's confident they'll find a way to break through sooner or later.
For the Pirates.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Now it'll be Poi-Jun Park. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base paths if they can get somebody on. With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
At the plate now, Kenta Maeda. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. One and two.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from five shutout innings.
Hard hit to first. Right to him. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Pirates. Still down 3-0. At the plate now is Jonathan India. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning.
Jonathan.
As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. Lifted in the air out to right. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
Number 44.
Digging in next, Aristides Aquino, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
That's just quality pitching right there for that strikeout. Some guys are real good low ball hitters, but more often than not, keeping the ball down is going to lead to a lot of success on the mound.
Mike Moustakas will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. This one's flared out toward left. Hayes is there, and he makes the catch to retire the side. Reds are down in order. They lead it 3-0. So now into the box is Key Brian Hayes. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
Key Brian Hayes.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Grounder down the line at third. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away. And definitely worth another look with our show track depth. Great reaction from the hot corner to make the backhand stop, and then he unleashes that very strong throw while in the air all the way across the diamond. He's going to be smiling about that one. So now it's Brian Reynolds. And she'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch. It's strike one.
This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And quickly there are two away.
Now this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
At the plate, Bobby Bradley. Bouncer up the middle. That's through, a base hit, and he's got his third hit of the game.
Well, these days don't happen often. You better dig yourself when you get three knocks in a big league way to go.
It's hard to have three hits in one day, but boy, this guy is off to a great start at this point.
Into the box now, Travis d'Arnone. As he'll take a look at ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far.
Held scoreless on the scoreboard, he was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs, but then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
Stepping in next, Dylan Carlson. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. First pitch of the AB now.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Now the 0-1. Swing and a hard liner to center field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Pirates strand a couple. They trail it here 3-0. So now to the plate, Colin Moran. He'll lead things off against Kenta Maeda. Now here's the first offering. Swing and a liner. And a reaching effort, but it comes up empty as this is past him toward the corner. And the Reds get a man into scoring position on the leadoff double.
The fans didn't even get a chance to settle in their seats now for the beginning of the inning. And he just blistered that ball down the line on the first pitch he saw. It stayed fair, and he's safely on second with the leadoff double. That's the way you lead off an inning.
Stepping in now, Tyler Stevenson, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. No hits to this point. And this one's in the dirt, and the runner will stay put, but the count moves to 2-0. Has a look, now the pitch. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. This misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Now batting, left fielder, Jake.
Next, it'll be Jake Fraley, 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. Now the first pitch. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
The 1-0 home finds the zone, strike one. And oh, this one's by him to the backstop. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. So now two men in scoring position.
Man, it was already a dicey situation with two on and no out. And then things get worse with the wild pitch there. So instead of a chance to turn two, they've got runners on second and third. And a base hit will drive in a pair.
Ball four as this one gets away a bit.
These guys on defense are still within striking distance, but after that walk, one swing of the bat could really blow this thing wide open.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Luis Castillo. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Here's the Pirate skipper up out of the dugout, now on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a move, as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll leave after six and at the very least kept his club in it to this point. Richard Rodriguez is summoned in the toughest situation a reliever can face. Bases loaded, nobody out. Now the manager brings his outfield in here with the pitcher at the plate. Doesn't want to get burned on any weak bloopers. Here's the first pitch to him. And it's the outside corner. It's strike one.
Pitcher on the mound has to find a way to minimize damage right here. Got to believe he's willing to trade two outs for a run.
And he misses with it, 1-1. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Hart ranging into the outfield. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
I can tell you from experience, bases loaded, nobody out, and you get an infield pop-up, that feels just as good as a strikeout. And now he's just a double play ball away from getting out of this mess.
So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And that brings up the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. First pitch on the way, fouled off. Close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
And this is swung on and missed. A huge out there as the bases will stay loaded with two away now. Next to dig in, Nick Senzel, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Looking to wiggle out of this, here it is. Fouled away. Comes set, the 0-1. I had him reaching a thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
Hey, this is a huge pitch right here. It would be demoralizing to watch this inning slip away.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon Business Person Special following this. plate. Here is Andrew Vaughn. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame.
Andrew Vaughn.
First pitch on its way. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up.
In the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Anytime you get rookies just breaking into the big leagues, you have to expect a certain amount of this. There aren't any easy at-bats at this level, and you really have to learn how to slow the game down in your head because everything feels like it's so much faster up here.
To the plate now, Hyun Park lifted down the line in left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. He flew out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim most recently. Ball one.
One ball, one strike.
No runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. It's like magic or something. He's given up a boatload of hits, but they haven't been able to chase a runner home.
Yeah, he's got the outs when he's needed them and seems to be really comfortable pitching from the stretch. Hard to keep that up over several innings, though.
Cannon Smith will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 24, Cannon Smith.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. As he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. Hit in the air out to center field. Senzel is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Up next for Pittsburgh, the shortstop. Oh yeah.
And stepping in, O'Neill Cruz grounded out in his last at bat.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. This one is launched. Look at this. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So it's a two-run shot to right center. First home run of the campaign for him. And the Buccos have made this a 3-2 ball game.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat, being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Red Skipper up out of the dugout and making that slow trek to the mound. And a change is in the offing as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. So a good job all in all this afternoon, and as it stands, he can only win this one as he departs with a one-run lead. Art Warren is into the ballgame now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here.
Number 77, Art Warren. Now back, the third baseman. Keith Ryan.
Into the box, Keith Ryan Hayes. As he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Swing for ball three. swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. But the Pirates do get a couple here on this two-run home run. We're through seven this afternoon. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Yusmeiro Petit is out from the bullpen now as he'll be making his first appearance of this young season. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Jonathan India. He sends it on the ground softly to the left. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. A look there at the numbers for our two starters here today, with both guys recently departed from the ball game and looking on from the dugout. Next to hit, Aristides Aquino. He went down on strikes last time up. First offering on its way. Now the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Going back is the right fielder. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Now at the plate, here is Mike Moustakas. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Reds, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Pedro Strop is out from the bullpen now as he'll be making his first appearance of this young season. Pedro Strop. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring up Brian Reynolds.
Leading up for the Pirates, the center fielder, Brian Reynolds.
First pitch of the AB now. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll step on first himself for the out. Up next for the Buccos, Bobby Bradley. He's got three hits, including a double to this point. He's set. Here it comes.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
Now the 1-0 is swung on, missed, and that's strike one. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pot commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
This is the pitch I think we'll see a lot from him in this game. The cutter darting in on the hitters in the opposite batter's box. It can be a real effective pitch when it's located well, and that one was right there.
So now to the plate, Travis d'Arnaud. As he'll get a slider up that time, but he swings through it for the first strike. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. In the air now out to left field. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. They trail 3-2. set to start the ninth in this one, and set to go is the veteran first baseman Colin Moran. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Never looking for it.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1, and he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield, and there's the first out.
Now batter, the catcher, Tyler Stevenson.
Next to stand in is Tyler Stevenson. He's 0-for-2 with a walk thus far. Swing and a liner, and that is through into center field for a one-out single. Another full count pitch home.
Nope, that's ball four.
And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Haven Smith will get the call to pinch hit here, and he'll find he has a couple of runners aboard with only one out in the inning. Aaron Fletcher enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number nine.
Aaron.
He'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one. And this is just off the outside corner, ball two.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Hit weakly back to the mound. And indeed, he'll not even try as he goes to first, and that means two men are in scoring position now with two away. And now here is J.P. Crawford, struck out in his last trip to the plate. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. And the slider bounces, and that'll get on by. What a bad time for a wild pitch as the run will score from third.
Man, he's out there trying to throw strikes and give his guys a chance to come back and maybe win this thing, but that wild pitch and the insurance run it allows to score certainly aren't helping matters in the slightest.
Ready with the 1-0.
That ball two.
Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. Grounded back up the middle. Reined in. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. Reds will be forced to settle for just the one. Sixth, seventh, and eighth place hitters scheduled to start the bottom of inning number nine. Reds out in front, 4-2. Lucas Sims takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And digging in is the outfielder, Dylan Carlson.
Right fielder, Dylan.
Here it comes.
Count 1-0.
Right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Now here's a fly ball. Well hit. Racing back, the right fielder. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as it's trimmed to a 4-3 game now.
I know hindsight's 20-20, but you can't throw that pitch to that guy. Don't forget, he homered yesterday, so you know he's locked in and ready to roll up there. We'll see if he learns from that mistake.
In now, Andrew Vaughn. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Grounded to short. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Now back, second baseman, Hoi Joon Park.
Now at the plate, Hoi Joon Park. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. Even at 2-2. Taken high and deep to right. And there's your tying run at second base with a one-out double. And if you start thinking about what remains on the Bucks bench, there they are. We'll see if one of them gets a call to pinch hit soon. Michael Chavis will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 31, Michael.
First pitch on its way. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. One delivery lays one off the one. Slider, and it's 1-1. Bonds now the pick. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. One out and a runner on second base. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. TJ Antone takes over on the mound now as he'll try to get the final out of the ball game here and pick up a save.
Your attention, please. Now, number 70.
O'Neill Cruz will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away.
Yeah, Matt, going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Ready with the 0-1.
1-1.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And that's taken for strike two, as now they're down to their final strike here this afternoon. Pittsburgh down to their last strike. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. The Cincinnati Reds used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Luis Castillo takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Always broken, I guess I'm starting over. Now my battered soul is going back through emotions. I'm just having a hold, was that no control? It's breaking my old, it's happening over and over again. That wasn't yours.
The final line score for our thank you.
Thank you.